Factoring tricks, perfect squares. You may recall that if we have a binomial that was squared, we got a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. If we can recognize this form, we can use it to factor back to this form. We look for that by seeing if we can take the square root of the first and last term, and it could be a perfect square. Let's take a look at our two examples. I can take the square root of the first term. The square root of x squared is just going to be x. If I take the square root of 25, I get 5. So then it's a good chance that I got a perfect square. So all we have to do is check the middle term. Is the middle term 2 times our square root of our first term times the square root of our last term? That was our middle term, 2ab. And in this case, yes, it gives us a negative. That means that this is a perfect square trinomial. So I put the square root of the first term, the square root of the last term, and this sign in the middle just comes down and the whole thing's squared, and I factored it. If you don't see that right away, it's not a big deal. You can factor using the trial and error method that we had before. But if you can recognize it, it makes it a really nice way to factor something really quick. So let's take a look at example 2. Can I take the square root of 9x squared? The answer is yes. In fact, the square root of 9x squared is 3x. Can I take the square root of 25y squared? Yes, it is 5y. Now, if I multiply all of that by 2, do I get 30? 2 times 3 is 6, 6 times 5 is 30. So yes, the answer is yes, it's a perfect square. So again, I can just put my parentheses. Square root of the first term is 3x. Square root of the last term is 5y, and my middle term is a plus, so I just bring that down here, put that there, raise the whole thing to a second power, and it is factored. Again, you can use trial and error, but if you recognize it as a perfect square, it goes fast.